Well, if I hadn't read what you wrote about Gujarat and what happened there, I would never have known, because people in the United States do not know what's happening in India.
Yeah.
In fact, people in the United States generally know very little about what is happening in the rest of the world.
Thanks to the free press.
Yes. You know, and it's clear that what we need more and more, you know, is this, you know, interchange across boundaries.
Yeah.
And the
real globalization.
Yeah, people's globalization. You know, you talk about that. And, because I sort of feel like, you know, I see the world with sort of chalk lines dividing everybody, and I see us as having the job of little by little walking across those
and rubbing them
and
out.
Those chalk lines out.
That's why I keep saying that I think literature is the opposite of a nuclear bomb. You know, when I wrote The God of Small Things, I would go to Estonia and Finland and hear from China, and people say, oh, but this was my childhood. One of the reasons why I never wanted it to be made into a film was because I thought there are 6 or 7 million films going on in people's heads, and this one filmmaker will come and take it away, you know. Let it be the world's childhood.
Yes.
And
yes.
You know, the idea that there is that, you know, that there is, the human beings across the world do share love and terror and gentleness and these things which literature links up and which nuclear bombs just build the walls and separate.
I think your coming here does that. Not only your writing does that, but you're coming here and us listening to you and knowing that, you know, we are part of a caress. I don't know, if any of you read Kurt Vonnegut's Cat's Cradle, you know, Kurt Vonnegut is this remarkable, you know, this remarkable, interesting, odd mind, you say. And in Cat's Cradle, he talks of a caress. He says, caress when people feel an affinity with one another. They don't know exactly why, but it crosses all lines. It crosses national, racial, sexual. It crosses all lines. But that's what we depend on.
Yeah, it's like I've never been to Pakistan. You know, Delhi and Pakistan, I mean Lahore, are maybe a 1 hour flight away from each other. I went to Pakistan last month. I had to go from Delhi to Dubai to Islamabad to Lahore. It took me 18 hours. And, you know, there's so much in the Indian press and equally in the Pakistan press about anti-India demonstrations and anti-Pakistan demonstrations, and we're all going to kill each other and everybody hates everybody and so on. I landed in Lahore, and within, you know, seconds, we were all sitting at this dining table, and I felt like I was in Delhi. It was just so sad, and the audience that came, people were just in tears, because not because of me or what I said or anything, just because it's such a relief not to always be subjected to this media's representation of government positions, you know. And I really feel that the media, the corporate media, has played a terrible part in all this, and people are just going to have to blow holes in this dam between them and insist on listening to independent real voices, real human beings.